on cleanness, their breath commonly stinks of pottage. To be chained and madged with one of them were to be tied to a dead carcass and cast into a stinking ditch. I do wonder that King James should be born in so stinking a town as Edinburgh in lousy Scotland. So you see now, you can even see the racism and the slandering going on. And see, what happened was, this guy was knighted by King James. And when King James, you know, got hold of all this stuff going on, he took him out. He, you know, he put him out of the court. You see what I'm saying? This is the truth. This is what's really going on. When you go into the Catholic, what the Catholic Church was doing, it's a known fact. The Catholic people tried to destroy him. That's what the Guy Fawkes deal is about in the movie V Vendetta. When it first comes on, it shows you this guy, Guy Fawkes, trying to blow up Parliament. And at the end, he does eventually, well, the guy, V, does blow up Parliament. But this is a real story of a guy named Guy Fawkes who was trying to kill the black king of England and Scotland, King James. He was trying to kill him. It was all racism. It was all dealing with the Catholic Church. You see? This is what it's all about. Like I said, you can go back once again. The man had 9 wives. The man wrote poetry and love letters to his wives. You can go look this up. But you know what you're going to do? You're still going to want to find ways to make it seem as if this man was doing all this. Okay? That's just how it is. You can say whatever you want, you know. So it doesn't matter. You know what I'm saying? King James VI, you know, he's the founding monarch of the United States, man. I'm just telling you exactly like it is. Okay? This is just how it is. Now, you can sit there and say whatever you want to say, but the dude brought the scriptures out for one particular reason, because we Hebrews, Judah, the tribe of Judah, which he descended from, he may have inadvertently not known what he was doing. I don't really care to prove that he was this righteous man or nothing like that. That's not what my stance is. But I do know that the Most High was giving us a way to have the records in the English language, which we would be enslaved in.
Guy Fawkes is the name we associate most closely with the plot. When, at about midnight on the 4th of November 1605, a search party discovered him lurking in the vaults beneath the House of Lords. He was just hours away from blowing apart the very fabric of the English state.
Out! Out!
What is your name?
18 months of meticulous planning and deception were foiled by this arrest.
What are the names of your accomplices in this terrible endeavor?
Well, of course, this is only the beginning as far as the government are concerned. They know nothing apart from the fact that they've caught this stranger standing guard over nearly a ton of gunpowder.
Take him away.
But who are his associates? Who was he linked to? Stark, Fawkes isn't saying anything. Indeed, when he's dragged before the sleepy king on the morning of the 5th of November and the king asks him why on earth he should have done such a thing, Fawkes says, "I wanted to blow you back to your Scottish mountains."
So why did Guy Fawkes want to blow the king back to his Scottish mountains? While writing a book exploring the religious backdrop to the gunpowder plot, I looked at this question again and again. But what soon became clear was that, despite his popular association with the plot, the answer to it didn't lie with Fawkes. He is not the key to this story.
The ringleader of the plot was Robert Catesby, not Guy Fawkes, although Guy Fawkes has got lumbered with it. He's got lumbered with being burnt on November the 5th. I don't think we can really understand the plot unless we understand Catesby. People adored him. He was one of those men people would follow to death.
There's a charisma to Catesby, there's, if you like, a black glamour to the man. He is a mix of a very devoted Catholic, at the same time, a man whose purpose in this particular plot is revenge.
There were 5 core plotters: Catesby, Fawkes, and 3 others. Thomas Percy, the oldest of the group, soon to become a bodyguard in the royal household. Tom Winter, who was Catesby's cousin and right-hand man. And Jack Wright, who was considered to be the best swordsman in England.
They saw themselves as being soldiers of Christ, the true soldiers of Christ. They had swords engraved with the words, the Passion of Christ.
Okay, so you got us Negroes right here today speaking English. So us being Hebrews, we would need our Hebrew records in a language that we would be speaking. As the scriptures say, with a stammering tongue or with stammering lips, we're going to be praising the Most High. And that's it. English is a bastard language. But it is very detrimental that we learn English and that we had our Torah translated into English. This is the only way. So you talk about King James being a homosexual. It came from a Caucasian man by the name of Anthony Weldon. Google him. Go get the books. Research. Listen, this is exactly what I'm telling you. I'm quoting the man what he said out his own damn book. So you can't tell me, you cannot prove to me that King James was a homosexual, because he was not a homosexual. The man had 9 children. The man got poetry and everything writing it to his wife. The man condemned homosexuality. And not only that, if the man was such a homosexual, the scriptures would have been translated allowing homosexuality. Why would he condemn himself in front of the populace? Why would he have these people authorized, give the authorization to have this version translated into English from the Hebrew and the Greek text, translated into English, just so, which condemns homosexuality, by the way, just so he can be ashamed when people read it and say, well, the king gay. They knew he wasn't gay. Anthony Weldon made that up 25 years after King James died. It's kind of hard to defend yourself when you've been dead 25 years. This is the truth. Can't deal with it. If you can't deal with it, just move along. But this is the truth. Okay? This is the truth. This is the absolute truth. Nobody can really deal with this because I'm telling you exactly what time it is. The Jesuits tried to have this man killed multiple times. The Guy Fawkes one is the most popular. King James was king at that time, you see?